بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
شروع اللہ کے نام سے جو رحمان و رحیم ہے.
اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق.
پڑھو اے نبی اپنے رب کے نام کے ساتھ جس نے پیدا کیا.
خلق الانسان من علق.
جمے ہوئے خون کے ایک لوتھڑے سے انسان کی تخلیق کی.
اقرأ وربك الاکرم.
پڑھو اور تمہارا رب بڑا کریم ہے.
الذي علم بالقلم.
جس نے قلم کے ذریعے سے علم سکھایا.
علم الانسان ما لم يعلم.
انسان کو وہ علم دیا جسے وہ نہ جانتا تھا.
Assalamu alaikum. We start our class with the name of Allah who is the most beneficent and most merciful. This is class 4 and the period is English language teaching E3 and I am your E3 teacher. This is our second video and in this video we will study the stuff of week number 3. So let's start the video. Come to the today's class topic here. These are our today's class topic. Today's class topics are, today we start to study chapter 26, what are infinitive. Today we study about infinitive and learn what is infinitive. Then we have a chapter number 27, what is gerund. Then after the infinitive we study about the gerund. And in our oral part, as you know, our subject is divided into two parts. One is for grammar and the second one is for oral practice. So our oral practice, for oral practice part, we have today talk in pair. Before starting the today's video, let's have a small recap of our previous video, what we had studied or learned in our previous video. In video number one, in our previous video, video one, we had studied the stuff of week number two. In our previous video, we had studied about the transitive and intransitive verb and linking verb. And in our language portion, we had a conversation. So let's revise this. Let's revise it again. What is transitive verb? Yes, transitive verb. Yes, what is a transitive verb? As I told you that a verb that requires an object to complete its sense is called transitive verb. Ek aisa verb jisko apna sense complete karne ke liye object ki need hoti hai, those verbs are called in a transitive verb. For example, Ali saw a cat. In this sentence, Ali is subject and so is verb and cat is object. So this is a transitive verb. So is an intransitive verb is used as intransitive. Why? Because if we say Ali saw, then obviously a question is raised in your mind. Ali saw what? Ali ne kya dekha tha? Theek hai na? So it means you need an object. So this is called transitive verb. In transitive verb, the object, the verb has a direct connection with the object. Ki aapke paas transitive verb mein object ka direct connection hota hai and they never form without the object. Aur ye kabhi bhi object ke bina nahi aa sakte hain because they never give, without the object they never give the complete sense of sentence. Kyunki object ke bina wo kabhi bhi sentence ka complete sense nahi dete hain. Okay, then after the transitive, we had studied about intransitive verb. Intransitive verb. What is intransitive verb? A verb that doesn't require an object to complete its sense is called intransitive verb. Ek aisa verb jisme object ki need nahi hoti hai apne sentence ko complete karne ke liye, use hum intransitive verb kehte hain. For example, birds fly. In this sentence, birds is subject and fly is verb. Okay, in this sentence there is no object. Is sentence mein aapke paas koi object nahi hai, but without the object, if you examine this sentence, it gives you the complete sense of sentence. Bina object ki bhi ye aapko complete sense de raha hai. Jaise ki birds fly, परिंदे उड़ते हैं दे डजंट नीड एनी ऑब्जेक्ट दिस इज कॉल्ड इंट्रांजिटिव वर्ब आफ्टर द इंट्रांजिटिव वर्ब वी स्टडी अबाउट द लिंकिंग वर्ब आफ्टर द इंट्रांजिटिव वी स्टडी अबाउट लिंकिंग वर्ब Yes, what I told you about linking verb. Linking verb means or linking means to connect or join. A verb that connects the connect is subject to its additional information is called linking verb. एक ऐसा verb जो subject को उसके describe जो की गई है उसकी information जो भी आपको दी गई है उसे connect करें those verbs are called linking verb. For example, Ali. Seems happy. This is the sentence. In this sentence, Ali is subject. Seems is a linking verb and it is the additional information. Or you can say adjective. If we say Ali happy, we don't use the word seen here, then it doesn't make the complete sense. Ye aapko complete sense nahi de raha hai. Ali happy. Ali happy what? That's why we need a connection to complete the sentence. We provide the word Ali seems happy. Ali happy dikhta hai. Isi wajah se hum isko linking verb kehte hain. Linking verb doesn't show any action. Linking verb kisi kaam ko ya action ko show nahi karte hain. They just connect the subject to its additional information. Ye sirf subject ko uski additional information se connect karte hain, link karte hain. As you can see in the example, Ali seems happy. Here the word seems connect the Ali to its additional information happy. So that's why linking verb, this is called linking verb and that's why linking verb called as joining or connecting. So these were, so this is our previous video topic. These are our previous video topic. Now come to the today's video topic. Okay, our today's video first topic is chapter 26, what are infinitive? Yes, chapter 26, the name of the chapter is what are infinitives? इन्फिनेटिव्स आपके पास क्या होते हैं द बेस फॉर्म ऑफ द वर्ड दैट यूजुअली फॉलोड बाय टू इट्स कॉल्ड इन्फिनेटिव यस व्हाट इज इन्फिनेटिव द बेस फॉर्म ऑफ अ वर्ड दैट यूजुअली followed by two. The base form of the verb that usually followed by two is called infinitive. Is called infinitive. एक ऐसी वर्ब की फर्स्ट फॉर्म जो टू के साथ हम यूज करते हैं उसे हम इन्फिनेटिव कहते हैं नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज द बेस फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब वर्ब की बेस फॉर्म क्या होती है एज ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट द वर्ब हैज मेनली अ थ्री फॉर्म किसी भी वर्ब की थ्री फॉर्म होती है नंबर वन इज बेस फॉर्म सेकेंड वन इज पास्ट फॉर्म And third one is past participle. These are the forms of verb. What is this? These are the form of verb. Base form means first form. For example, eat and past form, you can also say it second form of word. It means at. Third past participle is third form, means eating. So these are the three basic form of the verb, and they use according to the sentences. In infinitive, we say that the first form of the verb that followed by two is called infinitive. Base form, यानी कि जो first form होती है, that had no change, इसमें कोई भी change नहीं होता. Initial form of verb, if verb means any action, it's called infinitive. For example, base form of the verb means eat. Base form, eat. And base form of the verb is usually followed by to, means to. This is called infinitive. Yes. So this is called infinitive. The base form of the verb that usually followed by to, it's called infinitive. And how you form infinitive, or aap infinitive ko kaise form karenge? Okay. So what is the structure of formation of? Now, formation of infinitive. आप infinitive को कैसे बनाएंगे? Formation of infinitive means structure, or how you form a infinitive from a verb. But always remember, the infinitive is a verb, but its verb or its function as a noun, adjective and adverb. But first come to the formation, कि आप किसी भी, हम कह रहे हैं कि infinitive verb की first form होती है, but how do you form it? आप इसको कैसे बनाओगे? ठीक है ना, base a first two plus first form, or you can say base form of verb. Base form of verb is equal to infinitive. This is the structure. Yes, this is called infinitive. For example, the base form of the verb of any verb, play. Then we add to here, it's mean the verb become infinitive. This is called infinitive. Some more examples, lie, swing. Add to here, before the verb, before the base form of the verb, we add to. This is how we make infinitive. इसे हम इस तरह से infinitive बनाते हैं. I hope you have got this, how we form infinitive. ठीक है ना, and what are the examples of infinitive, how you form? To eat, to swim, to run, to eat, or anything that you add before the, you add to before the verb, it's become infinitive. Now come to the uses of infinitive, where we use infinitive, and what are the uses of infinitive. I hope you have got this, what is infinitive and how it's formed, and what are the examples of infinitive and how you form examples of infinitive. Okay, to play, to swim, to run, to run, to like. This is how you will make the examples of infinitive. We also see infinitive sentence examples when we see the uses of infinitive. Okay, so this is a very basic examples of infinitive. Now come to the uses of infinitive. Our next topic is uses of infinitive. As I told you, कि the infinitive made from the verb. Infinitive हम verb से ही बनाते हैं, but it doesn't function like a verb. But ये function verb की तरह नहीं करते हैं. They function as noun, as adjective, or as adverb. Infinitive verb से तो form की formation होती है उनकी, लेकिन वो कभी भी verb का काम नहीं देते हैं किसी भी sentence में. They work as adjective. ये adjective की तरह काम करते हैं sentence में. They function as noun. ये function में noun की तरह काम करते हैं. And they can function as adverb, और ये adverb की तरह भी किसी भी sentence में work करते हैं. So this is the uses of infinitive. Now come to the first one. use as noun. First we should know what is noun. I hope you all of you know that what is noun. I am revising you again. Noun means a name of a person, place, animal or thing. और यू कैन सी एनी नेम इज कॉल्ड नाउन और नेमिंग वर्ड आर कॉल्ड नाउन. किसी भी चीज़ का, इंसान का, जानवर का, जगह का जो नाम होता है, बेसिकली जो नाम है वो आपके पास नाउन कहलाता है. सो द इन्फिनिटिव वर्क एज नाउन. नाउन हाउ इट वर्क्स एज नाउन. एज यू नो कि इफ द सेंटेंस हैज थ्री मेन पार्ट, सब्जेक्ट, वर्ब प्लस ऑब्जेक्ट. दिस इज द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अ सेंटेंस. A sentence has three main components, subject, verb and object. If we are using a noun, we are saying infinitive use as a noun. So if the noun is used in any sentence, so it can use as a subject. Noun aapke paas subject ho sakta hai, ya phir noun aapke paas object mein ho sakta hai. So infinitive also used in a sentence in a two way, as a subject of a sentence or as an object of a sentence. Because subject and object both are noun on any sentence. So if the noun infinitive is worked in a sentence as a noun, so it must be like a noun or object, subject or object. Now come, first one is how the infinitive verb noun as subject and as object. सब्जेक्ट और ऑब्जेक्ट के तौर पे ये काम करेगा, कैसे करेगा. नंबर फर्स्ट वन इज ऑब्वियसली इफ वी आर सेइंग कि इन्फिनिटिव इज यूज एज अ सब्जेक्ट तो द सब्जेक्ट ऑलवेज कम एट द फर्स्ट इन एनी सेंटेंस. सब्जेक्ट हमेशा किसी भी सेंटेंस के स्टार्ट ही सब्जेक्ट से होता है. सो व्हाट इज इन्फिनिटिव, वी से दैट इन्फिनिटिव फर्स्ट हाउ टू, देन वी एड एनी वर्ड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई एम टेकिंग वर्ड हेल्प. Help is this is called infinitive. And why? Because two, when the base form of the word followed by two is called infinitive. Here the two and help, it means the word is infinitive and we are taking it as the first thing. To help other is good habit. Okay, so this is the first example of infinitive as a noun or as a subject, or as you can say, to play. To play verb, here it is infinitive, base form of the verb and add to, so the verb convert into the infinitive and we are using it as a subject. So to play cricket is enjoyable. This is how the infinitive is used as a subject or as a noun. Then come to object. As I'm saying, ki infinitive also work as noun or noun can be a subject and object. Now come to the object. Object means ek aisi cheez jo sentence ke end mein aati hai, hum use object kehte hain. So how the infinitive work as a object. She, this is the example, she always forgets to eat. She always forgets to eat. वो हमेशा खाना भूल जाती है. In this sentence, we use infinitive as a object. This is object, base form of the word followed by two. So this is how the infinitive used in a sentence as a object. Okay, some more examples like I wish to go. I wish to go in this sentence, where is infinitive? To go is infinitive and here it is used as a object of sentence. So this is how the infinitive used as a noun, subject or as an object. Now come to the second use of adjective, uses as a adjective. Yes, now the second use of adjective, that was the first one is a noun and second one is adjective, इन्फिनिटिव यूजेस एडजेक्टिव. ओके, फर्स्ट वी शुड नो व्हाट इज एडजेक्टिव. डिस्क्राइबिंग वर्ड्स आर कॉल्ड एडजेक्टिव, और द वर्ड दैट डिस्क्राइब द क्वालिटी ऑफ नाउन, क्वालिटी और एनीथिंग, और गिव द इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट नाउन, इट्स कॉल्ड द एडजेक्टिव. और यू कैन से अ वर्ड दैट क्वालिफाइज द नाउन, इट्स कॉल्ड एडजेक्टिव. तो हाउ द वर्ड इज यूज एज एडजेक्टिव इन एनी सेंटेंसेज, और इन्फिनिटिव आर ऑल्सो यूज एज एडजेक्टिव. ओके, हाउ इट इज यूज, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, first one is we are ready to play. If this sentence to play is an infinitive, and in this sentence the infinitive is working as a as a adjective, theek hai na. Number two is I can't wait to see is a infinitive, and the sentence is I can't wait to see, describe the adjective. So this is how the infinitive used in a sentence as a adjective. Now come to the third one, third use of infinitive. I hope you have got this. Yes, infinitive is also used as adjective. What is adjective? First we should know this. Adjective describing words are called adjective, or a word that qualifies the noun, or it's called adjective. ऐसा word जो आपको noun के बारे में information देता है कि noun की brief करे, वो आपके पास adjective कहलाता है, ठीक है ना. And infinitive is also used as a adjective, और infinitive आपके पास adjective के तौर पर भी use होते हैं. How? सही. आई हैव नो टाइम टू ईट. आई हैव नो टाइम टू ईट इन दिस सेंटेंस. टू ईट इज अ इन्फिनेटिव, एंड हेयर इट इज यूज एज अ एडजेक्टिव. ओके, नाउ कम टू द नेक्स्ट वन. Yes, I have nothing to say. In this sentence, to say is an infinitive, and here it is used as an adjective. Okay, now come towards the second, third use of infinitive, that is uses infinitive use as adverb. Third use of infinitive, use as adverb. We can also use infinitive as an adverb. हम infinitive को adverb पे भी use कर सकते हैं. What is a adverb? A word that define the verb, it's called adverb. Adverb mainly define the verb. Adverb क्या करते हैं आपको, mainly adjective को भी define करते हैं, noun को भी, but ये mainly verb को define करते हैं, ठीक है ना. So infinitive is also used as a adverb. For example, I can't wait to see. I can't wait to see. Here the word to see is an adjective. Okay, here the word to see is an infinitive, and in this sentence it is used as adverb. More example is we are ready to play. In this sentence, to play is an infinitive, and it is used as an adverb. So that's why we are saying ki infinitive used in a various way, in like a adjective, like a verb, like a adjective used as an adverb, as adjective, and as noun. If adjective is using as a noun, to a noun can be a subject or object. So we can say the infinitive is also used as subject and object of a sentence. I hope you have got this. What is infinitive and how it is used in a sentence and how it form. Now come to the our second, our next topic is we are learning about the infinitive, and I said about infinitive that the infinitive, what is infinitive? The base form of the verb that usually followed by two is called infinitive. Infinitive क्या होते हैं जो verb की first form के साथ अगर हम two को add कर दें उसे हम infinitive कहते हैं. But this is but in some cases we never use two to make the infinitive. Some words are also present in English dictionary that never follows the rule of two, जो कभी भी two को follow नहीं करते हैं. The second type of infinitive is bare infinitive, bare infinitive, bare infinitive. As you know that the infinitive has two types. Number one is full infinitive, full infinitive. And the second type of infinitive is bare infinitive. So this is the two type of infinitive, and this is how the infinitive is used in a sentence. If you are saying the full infinitive means if the infinitive is used with the two, it's mean it's called the full infinitive. Agar infinitive aapke paas two ke saath use ho raha hai use hum full infinitive kehte hain. But if the infinitive is used without the maker two, it's called bare infinitive. Agar aapke paas infinitive two ke bina bhi use ho raha hai to hum use bare infinitive kehte hain. It's not always a necessary to have a two with the verb to show that the verb is infinitive. ये हमेशा जरूरी नहीं है कि किसी verb के साथ हम two को add करेंगे तो ही वो word infinitive होगा. In some cases we also a bare infinitive is also present. Now first we should know what is bare infinitive. Bare infinitive means when the verb is used without the two. It's called yes, this is called bare infinitive. Yes, when the verb is used without the two, जब कोई verb टू के बिना यूज होता है तो हम उसे बेयर इन्फिनिटिव कहते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल प्ले, ठीक है ना. हेयर द वर्ड इज प्ले, बट इन बेयर इन्फिनिटिव वी नेवर यूज टी विद इट. Bare infinitive means a verb that doesn't have to be used without the two. Aisa verb jo two ke bina use hota hai, hum use bare infinitive kehte hain. Theek hai na? For to its mean to pleat is a full infinitive. To play means full infinitive hai aapke paas. ठीक है ना. बट वेन वी डोंट यूज मेकर टू विद अ वर्ड और बट द वर्ड इट्स फंक्शन एज अ नाउन, इट्स प्रोनाउन, इज अ नाउन, इट्स ऑल्सो अ इन्फिनिटिव, उसे हम बेयर इन्फिनिटिव कहते हैं. बेयर इन्फिनिटिव, ठीक है ना. बेयर इन्फिनिटिव में हमारे पास वर्ब की सिर्फ फर्स्ट फॉर्म यूज होती है, टू यूज नहीं होता है. बट फुल इन्फिनिटिव जो मेन इन्फिनिटिव आपके पास होते हैं उसमें हम वर्ब के फर्स्ट फॉर्म के साथ टू को यूज करते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल लेट, लेट देम प्ले, लेट देम प्ले. Always remember we never use maker to infinitive with a modal verb. Modal verb के साथ हम कभी भी infinitive को use नहीं करते हैं, can, should, well, could के साथ, ठीक है ना. In this sentence let them play, ठीक है ना. This is the bare infinitive example. We never said let them to play, it give the wrong sense of the sentence. So we say simply let them play. We never use to here. Okay, now come to the next one is I had her sing. I had her sing, पहले उसे गाते हुए सुना था. Here the verb is sing and we They didn't use two here because if we put two here, it gives a wrong sense of the sentence. This is called pair infinitive. When we use the verb used without the two, is called the pair infinitive. So this is the two types of infinitive: full infinitive and pair infinitive. Full infinitive means a verb that come with the maker two. एक ऐसा verb जब two के साथ use करते हैं, उसे हम full infinitive कहते हैं. और the second one, if the verb doesn't use with the maker two, अगर कोई verb अगर हम बिना two के use करते हैं, उसे हम bare infinitive कहते हैं. So this is all about the infinitive. I hope you have got this. What is infinitive? Do the verb of infinitive from the solution that will provide you from the school. Do all the copy work in your copy and book work in your book, but don't forget to give the heart in your copy that this exercise of this unit is solved in book. Solve in book and also indicate the page number on that page. Okay, now come to the book exercises. As all of you know, our book is also important. This is your book, Renan Martin. We are learning grammar from this book. And exercise 2, book page 101. Solve this exercise on your book. This is your exercise, page number 101, and exercise number 2 is included in your syllabus. Okay, the question of this exercise is: complete the following sentence using ing form or to infinitive. Some sentences are given to you with the option. You have to choose from the infinitive and ing which option is correct in the sentences. For example, complete the sentences. Question is, complete the sentence. Okay, number one is, I had started dash when I was 20. This is the blank and options are also given. A is to teach. Number B is teaching. Or C is, either could be used here. Either could be used here. So how do you solve this exercise? First, you should know what is the sentence, what they are saying in the sentence and what kind of sentence it is. कि ये सेंटेंस किस चीज के बारे में और आपको किस चीज के बारे में पूछ रहा है, ठीक है ना. I had started dash when I was 20. मैंने पढ़ना शुरू किया, मैंने शुरू किया था dash when I was 20, जब मैं 20 साल की थी. To teach or teaching would either could be used here. Here we use infinitive because infinitive tells about infinitive. Infinitive are the future oriented. आपको future oriented के बारे में बताते हैं और oriented आपके पास infinitive as a noun भी use होते हैं. So I had started to teach. This is how you will solve the exercise in your book. Number 2 is, I am fond of dash. I am fond of dash. Always remember, we never use infinitive with preposition. We always use gerund with preposition. Hum kabhi bhi infinitive ko preposition ke saath use nahi karte. We always use gerund with preposition. Hum gerund ko jo noun ki ek aur form hai use hum use karte hain preposition ke saath. In this blank the ing form answer was correct. So this is all about infinitive. I hope you have got this, and this is how you will solve this exercise in your book. But don't forget to give the heart in your copy. That exercise number 2, book page 101, is solved in book. Okay, now come to our next topic. Our next topic is, what is gerund? Chapter 27. What is gerund? Gerund आपके पास क्या है? What is gerund? Gerund is also a verb, but its function as a noun. When we use a verb in place of a noun is called gerund. Yes, what is a gerund? when we use a verb as noun is called gerund. When we use a verb in place, in place of a noun. जब हम किसी verb को noun की जगह पे use करते हैं, वो आपके पास gerund कहलाता है. And gerund is also a verb, but is functional as a noun. Gerund आपके पास एक verb होता है, लेकिन वो आपके पास एक noun का काम देता है. उसे हम gerund कहते हैं. And how it form? And फिर gerund हम कैसे form करते हैं? Now come to the formation of gerund. Formation of gerund, or you can say the structure of making gerund. The formation of gerund is add ing at the end of base form of verb. किसी भी वर्ब को जेरिड में कन्वर्ट करने के लिए हम क्या करते हैं, वर्ब की फर्स्ट फॉर्म के साथ हम आई एन जी एड कर देते हैं. तो द वर्ब बिकम द जेरिड, बिकॉज व्हेन वी एड आई एन जी इन टू द वर्ब बिकम अ नाउन, एंड नाउन इज अ जेरिड. अ वर्ब नाउन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड अ जेरिड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल प्ले, प्ले इज अ वर्ब, एंड हाउ टू मेक जेरिड प्लस आई एन जी, सो इट बिकम प्लेइंग. Playing, this is how you form gerund. Other example is eat, eat is a verb, or when we add ing into it, the verb eat become eating. Now I hope you have got this, what is gerund and how it form. Like an infinitive gerund also word, like an infinitive gerund is also a function as a noun. Gerund bhi aapke paas function karta hai noun ke taur pe. Or sometimes we also call a verb noun is also called gerund. Ek verb noun ko bhi hum gerund kehte hain. Theek hai na? What is also a gerund? A verb noun. एक वर्ब नाउन भी आपके पास जेरिन कहलाता है. क्यों? वाई? बिकॉज वी एड, फिर आज अगर वी कन्वर्ट द नाउन इन टू द वर्ब बाय एडिंग आई एन जी. एंड ऑलवेज रिमेंबर द जेरिन एंड विद द आई एन जी. एंड ठीक है ना, हमेशा जो जेरिन होते हैं वो आई एन जी के ऊपर एड होते हैं. द कम टू द एग्जाम्पल्स एंड रिमेंबर जेरिन, वेन वी एड द आई एन जी एंड द वर्ब कन्वर्ट इन टू द नाउन, इट नेवर गिव्स यू द और नेवर इंडिकेट्स द एक्शन. नाउन जो हम वर्ब को जब हम नाउन में कन्वर्ट करते हैं तो वो कभी भी एक्शन को रेफर नहीं करते. दे ऑलवेज फोकस ऑन द एक्टिविटी, यू नो एनी एक्टिविटी, वो एक्टिविटी को शो करते हैं आपके पास. ये कभी भी एक्शन को शो आपके पास नहीं करते. जनरल एक्टिविटी को ये फोकस करते हैं, ठीक है ना, एक्शन को शो नहीं करते. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, एग्जाम्पल आई लाइक स्विमिंग. I like swimming. In this sentence, word swimming is a gerund. आपके पास swimming क्या है? ये एक gerund है. किस तरह से हमने इसमें how swimming को add कैसे किया है? Word swim. Swim आपके पास क्या है? एक verb है. Word swim is a verb, but when we add ing into it, the verb become gerund and gerund function as a noun. As you can see in this sentence, I like swimming. In this sentence, the verb it's not indicate any action. किसी भी action को ये verb indicate नहीं करता है. और gerund जो है किसी action को indicate नहीं करते हैं. They just focus on the general activity. ये सिर्फ आपके पास एक general activity को बताते हैं. For example, eating sugar is bad for teeth. Eating sugar is bad for teeth. यानी कि शुगर आपकी दांतों के लिए अच्छी नहीं है. टू मच ईटिंग शुगर इट्स नॉट गुड फॉर योर टीथ. इन दिस सेंटेंस ईटिंग इज अ वर्ब नाउन इज अ जेरंड एंड एज यू इफ यू रीड दिस सेंटेंस केयरफुली देन यू विल फाइंड आउट द वर्ड ईटिंग इट्स नॉट इंडिकेट एनी एक्शन. इट जस्ट इंडिकेट और टेल यू अबाउट द जनरल एक्टिविटी. इस सेंटेंस में आपके पास ईटिंग आपके पास एक वर्ब नाउन है लेकिन ये किसी भी एक्शन को इंडिकेट नहीं कर रहा है बल्कि ये आपको एक एक्टिविटी बता रहा है कि ईटिंग शुगर इज बैड फॉर हेल्थ, बैड फॉर टीथ, इवन बैड फॉर हेल्थ. ठीक है ना. सो दिस इज द जेरंड. ओके, बट ऑलवेज रिमेंबर कि इन कंटिन्यूअस टेंसेस वी ऑल्सो यूज आईएनजी फॉर्म इन अवर कंटिन्यूअस टेंसेस. कंटिन्यूअस टेंस वी ऑल्सो यूज ING form. For example, I am watching TV. This is the sentence. This is the example. A sentence of continuous tense. I am watching TV. In this sentence, word watching also had a ing. It is a verb and add ing into it. इसमें हमने ing को add किया है. But is the verb is gerund? No. Why? Because gerund never give the any and never show any action. Gerund किसी भी action को show नहीं करते हैं. They just focus on the general activity. ठीक है. and it come in the continuous form with the helping verb. और ये helping verb के साथ आते हैं और gerund कभी भी helping verb में use नहीं होते. For example, now what is gerund? Watching TV is watching TV is good. In this sentence, the word watching is used, but in this sentence, the watching is not refer any action. किसी action को refer नहीं करते. They just straight the general activity. Watching TV is good. Sometimes watching TV is also very good because after watching TV, you can gain lots of information. So this is the gerund. And how do you differentiate the gerund from the continuous tense? If the word give the sense of the any action, it show any action or come with a be verb, it mean the word it's not gerund. If the verb give you the sense of any general activity, that means कि that word is gerund. इसे हम gerund कहते हैं. Okay, by the infinitive gerund, we also use gerund in a different way. Come to the uses of gerund. Uses of gerund. Gerund is a verb noun, तो obviously a gerund is also verb as a noun. Gerund आपके पास एक verb noun है तो वो verb की तरह ही noun की जैसे ही काम करेगा. It's also function as a noun. As a noun अगर हम ये काम करेंगे तो noun आपके पास two तरह से sentence में use होता है, as a object और as a subject. Object and plus subject. For example, I like swimming. In this sentence here, the word swimming is a gerund and it is used as a object and swimming is a noun. Swimming is good for health. Here the sentence start with the subject and the word swimming is a verb gerund and they are saying ki swimming is good for health. So this is how the gerund is also used as a subject and here as a object. Now we use gerund as a preposition. We use gerund with a preposition. हम gerund को preposition के साथ भी use करते हैं. For example, I am fond of reading. I am fond of reading. मैं reading की मतलब मुझे reading का शौक है, शौकीन हूँ. तो here the word fond of is a preposition and we use gerund with a preposition, but we never use infinitive with a preposition. And after this, we use gerund with the transitive verb. Transitive verb के साथ भी हम gerund use करते हैं. For example, I like reading stories. ठीक है ना. I like reading stories. Here the word reading indicates the gerund and we are saying that gerund is also used as a transitive object. ठीक है ना, ट्रांजिटिव ऑब्जेक्ट के साथ यूज हो रहा है, तो ट्रांजिटिव मीन एन ऑब्जेक्ट, हियर द ऑब्जेक्ट इज स्टोरीज. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द जेरंड. आई होप यू हैव गॉट दिस, व्हाट इज जेरंड. नाउ कम टू द बुक एंड एक्सरसाइज दैट ऑन द पेज 108, it's also included in your syllabus. I'm telling you how to solve this exercise. You will be able to solve this exercise after this lecture. Now come to the exercise, book exercise 3, page 108. In what they are saying, there is a list of a gerund and function. Write the sentence using the gerund as indicate. There are some gerund are used given to you, and also a indication to how do you use a gerund in a sentence. Number one, they are saying what gerund is given to you. Swimming as a direct object. आपने swimming को as a direct object use करना है. So I give you the information. She like swimming. Then number two is talking as an object of preposition. आपने word gerund talking को use करना है as a preposition. Like I am fond of talking. मैं talking की शौकीन हूँ बोलने की. Then running as a subject. आपने word gerund running को use करना है as a subject. Running consumes energy. So this is how you will do the remaining part of exercise by yourself after the lecture. I hope you have got this, what is gerund and infinitive. So that's it for our grammar portion. Now come to the our language portion. As all of you know that our subject is divided into the two parts. First one is for oral part and the second one is for grammar part. We have done here our grammar part. Now come to the oral part, language part, language portion. We have divided our subject. We have divided our subject into two parts, because when you are learning any language, so learning is not enough. Speaking is also very important. That's why we divide our subject into the two parts. For our learning, we have our talking pair today. For learning focus, we have topic, talking pair. Yes, in our language portion, we have talking pair, asker, two talking pair. Number one is ask question answer, and number two is make prediction. So as you know, the talking pair is a conversation, is a written conversation, and for conversation, you always need a partner. So I am telling you how to do this at your home with your partner. So I'm calling my partner. Okay, so please come in, miss. Assalamu alaikum. How are you, miss?
Fine. What about you?
I'm very good. I'm doing well. So this is my partner, and with her, I'm showing you how to practice talking pair at your home. You can practice it like us at your home with anyone from your family, with your sibling and friends. Okay, so let's start. Our first topic is ask question answer. Different question answer we'll ask in this talking pair. Hello. I'm feeling hot. Can I open the window?
Sorry, I'm cold.
Okay. I need to call my mom. Can I call my mother?
Yes, of course.
And can I take the pictures?
No, it's prohibited.
Oh, and what can I help you?
Yes, please bring some glass of water for me.
Okay, so this is our first conversation. Now come to the second talking pair. Second talking pair topic is make prediction of future. As you know that you are very clear, then you have a bit of curiosity about future. How you will talk about your future? I'm telling you. So let's start our conversation. Okay, hi miss, how are you?
I'm fine. What about you?
I'm good. Let's talk about future.
Sure.
So where would you like to live in future?
I will live in abroad. What about you?
Well, I won't leave Pakistan, so I will continue live in Karachi.
Yes, great.
And where will you like to live in future?
I will live
big house. I will live in a big house.
I will live become a boat house.
Okay, and she likes to live in a big house in her future. So where would you like to travel in your future?
If I will got a chance, I will like to travel the whole world. What about you?
Well, I will travel. I will buy a big house for my parents. And where will you work?
That's a great idea, but I won't buy a big house. I will buy a car.
Okay, and where will you work? I work as a teacher in school, because I want to become a teacher in my future.
I will become a scientist.
Okay, and
I will work in research laboratories.
So that's it. I hope, I wish that we had a bright future.
Inshallah.
So this is our talking pair about about our future. So you will also continue this pattern at your home. So that's it for today's class. Now take out your diary and note your week number 2 diary work. Your homework is, today we learn about infinitive and gerund. So I am giving the homework regarding these two topics. Make infinitive, make 2 sentences. Of infinitive, plus gerund. You will make 2 sentences of using infinitive and gerund. आपने gerund और infinitive की 2 sentences बनाने हैं. Then for oral practice, talk in pair. Practice talk in pair. This is your diary of video number 2. The date is 30 November to 5th December, day Monday to Saturday, and the subject is E3. So that's it for today's class. I hope you have got everything. If you have any problem, watch this video again and again so that your problem can be resolved. We will meet in our next video, video number 3. Till then, take care. Allah Hafiz.